Hello, welcome to this video on becoming a contributor on Kaggle. In this video, what we're going to do is register on Kaggle, and while we register on Kaggle, we'll become a novice. But our aim is to basically become a contributor, and I'm going to show you the several steps that are needed to become a contributor. So let's get started. First, I'm going to register or sign in. If you have not already registered, please register. I have an account, so I'm just going to re-log in into that account and show you the steps. So I'm going to sign in using my email ID. That's going to be kunal@gmail.com. And as soon as I log in, I will be basically guided to what I need to do to become a contributor from a novice. So if you see, I have this novice status for me here, but I'm just going to basically go through all of these steps. Some of the steps I've already done, and then become a contributor. First thing is obviously add your bio and your other details such that these four ticks are easily done. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm just going to go from here to my profile, right? And I'm going to say edit profile. I'm just going to add my name here properly. It's Kunal. And the occupation is going to be marketing advisor. I work at Dell, so it's going to be Dell, and then I live in Bangalore, so that's going to be Bangalore, Karnataka. I can also put my GitHub account link here. I can just take the name part of it here versus the whole link and paste it here. Similarly, if you have a Twitter account, you can add that here. Your LinkedIn profile also can be added. I'm just having the link here, so I'm just going to copy it here and paste the entire link here. And then if you have a website, I do have a website, so I'm just going to take that one and paste it here, right? So I put my basic details, and if I say save profile, I've basically checked off some of the details that I have done, right? However, now I need to also change my bio, and that is basically, again, you can go to the My Profile page and it will automatically take you to the home page here. And the bio is present at a sneaky level detail here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say edit here and add some details here. Okay, I'm just going to say, hi, I'm Kunal. I'm passionate about teaching data science. And do some spelling corrections. Okay, so I've done that, and basically saving that is the next step. So I've saved that, and now I can click the home button and see how much progress I've made. You'll see that progress bar has increased, which means I have done the top four part. I now need to basically SMS verify my account. So to verify my account, I'm just going to say SMS verify my account and click on this link. Go to the not verified section and then say +91. You can give your a country code and then provide your mobile number here, right? My mobile number is going to be some mobile number, and I'm going to say send code. Now you will basically receive the code on your mobile. What you can do is continue and then use the verification code to verify your account. Now once that's verified, you can go to home and see whether you have verified it successfully. Yes, you have verified it successfully. Now what we need to do is these final steps, right? So there's this these last steps that we need to do. Run one kernel, make a competition submission, make one comment, and cast one upvote. For casting one upvote, what you can do is just simply take any of the code or discussions that you have and just click on upvote, and it should be basically checked in, right? Now the remainder is these three. The other one, what we can do is make a comment, right? So what I have done is basically I have a code. I've provided this link in the section below. You can click on this link, and when you click and open this link, you can just upvote the link that I have provided and go to the comment section and just add a comment there, just self praise, and say post comment. And there should be that that work getting done there, right? So if you go back to home, you'll see that that one comment is also getting done, right? Now the final thing that we need to do is run one kernel and make one competition submission. For that, the same link you can use, right? I'm just going to paste it here, much like you'll be opening it. And what you can do is say copy and edit, much like I have it here, right? So you're going to say copy and edit. It's going to take some time and load it. So once, while it is loading, you'll see that you'll have the data sets that are there within the competition already loaded. You'll see the version, right? You'll see the sharing status and all of that. If you want to keep it private, you can keep it private. If you want to show it publicly, you can show it, right? People who want to keep it private basically do not want to show their code to anybody, hence they keep it private. But if you think you can share the knowledge, then you can just also share, put this sharing option to be as public. Also, you can use a GPU or a TPU accelerator in case you feel that your code is going to be taking a little longer to run and you want some speed up accelerator, then you can basically do that, right? So once you come to this particular page, right, what you can do is say run all, which is basically going to get you all the outputs that are required to solve this particular problem, right? And you're going to get also a submission file, right? So how do I know that? You can just come here and refresh it. You will see there will be a submission file that is available here, right? So once that is done, once this code is run, what you can do is commit, which basically saves this entire code. It'll take some time to save this code. Okay, so once it's done, what you can do is open the version that you just saved by clicking on that link, and you'll see that your code has is ready and it's executed, right? You can just go to the output section and select the output file that you have here and say submit to competition. So what this does is it puts you on the leaderboard at some location here. You'll see that this is your first entry and you're there on the leaderboard, which means you're now a contributor, right? So if you go back to home, you'll notice that all these sections that we require for a particular novice or a beginner level or a contributor level, sorry, are all checked in, right? So that's how you become a contributor on Kaggle. And obviously next steps is to participate in competition, contribute data sets, contribute in kernels and discussions. You can also do one more thing while you are here. Your profile requires a good picture. So what you can do is edit your profile and change your profile picture into something nice. I have one picture of mine, so I'm just going to upload that picture. Okay, preview image and update image. And that's how it's refreshed once you have uploaded your right picture.